honor of Disney's new movie, Mulan, the epic adventure about this cool girl who saves China. McDonald's is offering tender, crispy chicken McNuggets and a new Szechuan sauce.
For the past several years, we've been living in a nostalgia boom. It seems like every couple of weeks we hear that some 90s sitcom will be coming back, or that some classic 80s film will be getting a distant sequel with the decrepit original actors returning. I'd be tempted to say we're living in the golden age of nostalgia, but for the most part, these nostalgic revivals have been pretty disappointing. There have been the occasional serviceable gems, but the good nostalgia sequel to bad nostalgia sequel ratio is way off here. It seems for every Twin Peaks Season 3 or Star Wars The Force Awakens, we get a Ghostbusters reboot, an X-Files Season 10, and a Jurassic World. So why do sucky distant sequels hit harder than poorly received sequels that only come out a few years later? Perhaps in transposing an IP into the modern era and creating something that changes the fabric of a fictional reality instead of just pointlessly adding to it, the baby can be thrown out with the bathwater. Characters or concepts that audiences have held dear to their hearts are often challenged or ruined or retconned.
Without the midichlorians, life could not exist.
And these are stories that have been gestating with their fanbase for years and years. For some people, their entire lives. So how is it that Blade Runner 2049, a sequel which has come out 35 years after the original, has, by many accounts, surpassed or at least matched the critical success of the first film? Was the combination of direction, acting, cinematography, and story just a perfect recipe for success? Was the original Blade Runner just not that good? Mad Max Fury Road received a similar acclaim in 2015, despite being released decades after its predecessor. And while I credit director George Miller for maintaining the grip on the universe he created in a way that others have failed, part of its success is that Fury Road and all the other Mad Max films in the series are all so distinctly different from each other that they're basically incomparable. Mad Max Fury Road is a great film, but it's not a great sequel. Then on the opposite side of the spectrum, you've got The Force Awakens, which is so similar to A New Hope that you can't really say it's bad, it's just safe. I like the movie, but in terms of how it works as a sequel, the story threads it continues feel very much stacked upon the previous entries, as opposed to building upon any unresolved or loose plot lines. Blade Runner 2049 is unprecedented in the sense that it's the only distant sequel I can think of that actually continues the story on from the original in an organic way. It builds off a story that I didn't even realize was still lingering in the world of Blade Runner, instead of being drastically different in tone or story or characters, or being exactly the same, which is something you can't say for every sequel, whether it comes out 35 years later or not. Blade Runner achieved what Star Wars took 4 movies to get right on what was essentially its first attempt. And the fact that we've had 3.5 decades to ruminate over the original Blade Runner only for it to be matched by a compelling sequel makes that distance between them all the more satisfying and impressive. If The Force Awakens worked because it played it safe, and Mad Max Fury Road worked because it was so different and incomparable, Blade Runner 2049 works because it actually genuinely feels like a story that needed to be told in that particular universe. Which, if you ask me, makes it the most risky and the most effective distant sequel we've seen yet. Will Blade Runner 2049 signal a change for the nostalgia boom? Will we see more distant sequels to classic films that succeed in continuing the story in a way that doesn't feel unnecessary? What classic film would you like to see get a sequel this far down the line? Let me know what you think in the comments. And did you like Blade Runner 2049, or The Force Awakens, or Mad Max Fury Road? Geez, if you didn't, this must have been a frustrating one to listen to.
Henry! Henry, what is it?
It's Munchos!
Charlie, what is it?
It's Munchos!
Munchos, the new potato snack. So different, so delicious, so doggone munchy. Everybody wants to know what it is.